Well then, it's been some time since my review of Saga. If any of you don't recall or just didn't watch that video, in it I had several criticisms of the comic, its story, characters, and how the series hiatus has screwed any chance of it possibly continuing. And near the end of that video, I offered an alternate to Saga by recommending the sci-fi comic Descender and its sequel series Ascender. Well, I figured it'd be a good decision to do a review. This is Descender. Descender is a sci-fi series published under Image Comics. Written by Jeff Lemire and drawn by Dustin Jan, Descender is a series that focuses on a plethora of characters after a cataclysmic event that wipes away a good chunk of life in the universe. After said event, androids are now deemed illegal and are hunted down by various groups across the galaxy. One of our main characters, 1021, wakes up a decade after the event and goes on a journey that takes him to multiple worlds and other androids and possibly discover what caused the event in the first place. Robots and media have been portrayed in various ways, to logic bound malevolent calculators, rude joke machines, or those just wanna be human. Descender, however, does a clever blend, with characters like Driller, who is a simple-minded death machine, but still cares about his friends, to 1021, who, even though he is a robot, he still acts like a kid that is very innocent and naive, even though he's equipped with freaking repulsors. 1022, who is basically evil twin version of 1021. Hissius, the leader of the robot rebellion known as the Hardwire, set on galactic domination by artificially recreating the event that happened a decade prior. And these are only the main characters in the series. I haven't even touched some of the side ones that pop up in the story, or even brought up the connections and importance that 1021 has, mostly due for the sake of spoilers. The world of Descender is also one that is amazing and well crafted. It may not be as massive as Saga's, to make a quick comparison, in terms of things like scale and the amount of factions in it, but you do get a sense that there is a massive world up there, especially when you get to the later parts of the comic where magic is introduced and offers a bit of setup to the sequel series Ascender, but I'll talk about that beast at another time. Another thing to add about the world building is that there is a bit of Lovecraftian element to the story. I won't exactly say what it is for spoiler's sake, but similar to the Reapers in Mass Effect, there is an otherworldly force out there that is beyond our character's capabilities, and which by the end of the comic leads to a massive plot reveal and a cliffhanger that leads into Ascender. The art of Ascender is what I will also call style with structure. The watercolor style done by Dustin is a great unique style not done by many comic artists in the field, making it stand out even more, in a good way of course. The characters are well designed and dynamic, especially when it gets to the far more fantastical aspects of the story, but it's not without some faults though. There are a few times where the backgrounds are a tad bland. There does come the time where a few characters might blend into the background a tad, but that mostly happens when there is little detail and we are meant to see things from a distance. My only criticism of Descender is how sudden the ending kinda comes in. Without spoiling anything, it's a bit of a downer. Even though Ascender picks up after Descender, it still leaves a bit much to be desired. Like there was supposed to be more to happen exactly afterwards. Descender is an amazing sci-fi epic that has entertaining characters, gripping world building, and amazing writing that spans 32 issues. If you're a massive fan of robots, androids, or AI-based sci-fi stories, this is right up your alley.